Hey guys, what's up? So it is Sunday evening and I wanted to do a 90 days of loving me update video, and I haven't done an update video in a while, and the reason why I haven't done an update video in a while is because I've just been so busy with things in my own personal life, medical things that I'm dealing with. My sickle cell's really been bothering me, and keeping up with my organization and with my outreaches. So I haven't been diligent in doing the update videos. I'm not even sure what day I'm on, to be honest. And I was talking with a friend today, and I was just talking about things that I've been thinking about changing in my life, and these are like dramatic changes for me, and they're changes that are going to affect other people, but in order for me to continue growing, I need to always put myself first. And I always need to think about what's in my best interest, the best interest of my health, my well-being, mind, body, and soul. I have to put me first. And so for the past couple of weeks, I've just been thinking about changes that I need to make. And speaking with friends and having some situations happen really helped me come to the conclusion that, yeah, I need to make these changes. Otherwise, I'm going to be angry. I'm going to be upset. I'm going to say things that I don't want to say to my friends because I'm upset at something they said or something they did. So, if you recall in one of my videos, I said that my prayer is never that God change someone else. It's always that God change me. Change how I deal with that. Change how I handle this situation, or this roadblock, this obstacle, this challenge that's before me. God, change me. I hear so many people saying, well, I'll just pray for you. Well, my response is always, and sometimes those come from people with well intentions, but it's usually like if somebody gets mad at me, it's always like, well, I'll pray for you. And it's always me. And I don't want to be that person walking around saying to people, well, I'll just pray for you, when the person that really needs to be doing prayer is the person who's saying that, and the person that needs to be receiving prayer is the person who is saying that. So for me, I just never say that, and I've learned in the past 3 weeks that I really need to stay prayed up. And I really need to ask God, you know what, keep me humble, keep me grounded, keep me where I need to be in order for me to keep moving forward into greater works. So some of the things that I've been thinking about changing was social networking. I'm on a lot of social networks, and they take up a lot of time. In addition to that, I think many people come to my YouTube channel, my Facebook page, my Twitter page, Project Kenji Cat, my blog, thinking that I'm some type of therapist, or that I can take on all their problems. And I think people forget that I've got some things that I'm dealing with myself in addition to trying to run this organization, an organization that I created when I was homeless on the streets, an organization that is not funded, an organization that I love. And I think people forget that and immediately just want to dump things on me. Marital problems, drinking problems, drug problems, HIV issues, just all kinds of stuff. And at the end of the day, I find myself sitting here just so bogged down, so weighed down. And for the past 3 weeks, I've been thinking to myself, I can't continue to do this. I cannot continue to allow people to be like these Hoover and Dyson vacuums that just suck all the energy out of me. I just can't do that. I have a tendency to wear my feelings on my sleeve. My mom always used to tell me that. And when I say someone is my friend, they are truly my friend, and I am truly their friend. And things my friends say and do, not all the time, but sometimes friends say and do things that hurt. And I tell anybody that's getting to know me, it's best to tell me, hey, that hurt my feelings, or hey, I didn't like that, so I know right away. Don't let it fester and then it becomes this big blown out thing. Well, I did that with someone, and I was really, really hurt by what I got in return. This person is somebody that I respect, somebody that I love, somebody that is a great friend, and I didn't expect the reaction that I got, but I got it. And it hurt. It hurt. And that was, for lack of a better phrase, the straw that broke the camel's back. And that was like, okay, I need to make some changes. So again, I went back to, God, change the way I deal with this. And in order for me to keep growing and keep moving and keep up with my health and keep up with my organization, I am going to have to make changes to being online. So tonight what I did was I eliminated Facebook, I eliminated Twitter, I eliminated Pause I Am, I eliminated the Gay Travelers Network, I eliminated a bunch of things. So the only networks that I am keeping are the networks that I've created. Now, I've met some incredible friends on Pause I Am, Facebook, and Twitter. Many of these people are here on my YouTube channel. So some of the friendships I know will continue to grow. I just know they will, because they're true and genuine friendships. And others, I think, are going to suffer because my action is viewed as an attack, or me taking a friendship away, when all it really is me stepping back and taking care of me. Because at the end of the day, no one's gonna take care of me like me. No one's gonna look out for my health like me. No one is going to be here when I go into sickle cell crisis and can't handle it. So I need to remove some stressful situations and stressful people out of my life. I can't do it. And I think the reason why I haven't been doing the update videos is because I knew I needed to get to that point, and I knew this video was coming. where I need to let go of some things and... growth hurts. Because you want to hold on to what's there. But holding on to what's there holds you back. And I gotta move forward. I gotta move forward. So I wish you all peace and love. And if you are on my friends list and you have my phone number and you know how to reach me, please continue to reach out. Because I will continue to reach out. And just because I'm no longer a member of Twitter, Facebook, or Paws I Am, does not mean that our friendships can't grow. I really, really hope that they do. Peace and blessings, everybody. All love. This was my update video. Bye-bye.